Hi guys, welcome to the Fast Track series for RBI Grade B 2018, which has been brought to you by EduTap. Now, before moving on, let me just tell you about this series. Through this series, we are aiming to cover the current affairs from the month of May 2018 to August 15th, 2018. Now, we also aim to cover the ESI and FM concepts alternatively through the coverage of multiple choice questions. Let me just quickly tell you about our previous results. Since we have been working in this field for quite some time now, in 2017, 124 of our students reached the interview stage and 27 could make it to the final list. And here you can see the various courses, particularly for RBI Grade B, which are offered by EduTap, be it Phase 1, Phase 2, or the video course. You can just see here along with the MRPs. And let me just tell you that we are running a discount of 30% presently, and you have to use the coupon code FLASH30 to avail the discount. So in this particular video, we are going to cover the current affairs from 9th July up till 13th July 2018. So we aim to cover 5 days from this particular video. Okay, so before moving to the first news of the day, let me just tell you about the correction in the previous lecture 27th. See here, the Financial Action Task Force was mentioned, and we had mentioned there that FATF had 39 members, including India. But you can just take a note that FATF has actually 37 members. So please make a note of it. And yes, we do apologize for that. Moving on to the first news. So the first news of the day says, 6th edition of the World Cities Summit held in Singapore. So first of all, let me just tell you, it is important for you to know that this World Summit, City Summit, was held in which place? That is Singapore. And secondly, the theme is livable and sustainable cities, embracing the future through innovation and collaboration. Since you know that all the summits which are held, you need to know the location where these summits are held, and secondly, the theme, if any, of these summits. So moving on, let me just tell you about this World Cities Summit. It is a biennial international conference, that is, it is held once in 2 years, on public governance and sustainable development of cities. Now, since this is one of the part of the sustainable development goals as well, so that is why it is important for us. And just take a note that the first summit was also held in Singapore in June 2008, and the theme was livable and vibrant cities. So you see, now the 6th summit is taking place in Singapore again. So yes, that would be all. Moving on to the next news. So now this is important for us to know. 17th World Sanskrit Conference held in Vancouver, Canada. So first of all, this Canada, Vancouver becomes important for us to know. And telling you about this World Conference of Sanskrit, it is an international forum for professional researchers, that is researchers, educators, and all those who are interested in literature. They have this forum to discuss about the Sanskrit language particularly, that means to promote the language also. So here the conference was inaugurated by our Union HRD Minister Prakash Javrekar, and the main purpose of the conference is to promote, preserve and practice the Sanskrit language all over the world by the people. So now this is important for you to know where this was held and what is its main aim actually. Moving on. Our next news says, Satyarupa Siddhanta has become second Indian to climb world's highest volcano. First of all, it is important for us to know where is this world's highest volcano. It is in the Argentina and Chile border. It is Mount Ojas del Salado. And secondly, since Satyarupa Siddhanta has become the second Indian, we also need to know who was the first Indian. It is Mali Mastan Babu. So all these three informations are very important from this particular news. Moving on to the next news. 67th plenary meeting of Northeastern Council held in Shillong, Meghalaya. Now you see, we have learnt about this particular body, Northeastern Council, in the previous videos as well. So just to tell you that it is the nodal agency for the economic and social development of the Northeastern region, and it includes 8 states which have 7 sister states of Northeast and plus Sikkim. So just take a note of NEC, and this plenary meeting was held in Shillong, that is the capital of Meghalaya. So here is the sports section news. It says Deepa Karmakar has become the first Indian to win the gold in Gymnastics World Challenge Cup. So here it is important to know, as since she is the first Indian, so Deepa Karmakar is important to know here. And secondly, this Gymnastics World Challenge Cup was held at Mersin, Turkey. So Turkey also becomes important for us in this particular news. Okay, the next news is related to Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, a very important and flagship scheme of the government of India. So, according to the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban, they have notified that 51 lakh houses have been provided to the people as against the demand of 1 crore. So that means, you know, this becomes important to know that 50% of the demands were able to be met. So this is a very huge increase for the meeting of the demand of the people. And the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs is conducting its Central Sanctioning and Monitoring Committee, according to which this has been released. So let us see in detail about this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Shahri, that is urban. So the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana is a flagship program of the government of India, according to which the government is aiming to provide housing for all by the year 2022. So that is very important. And the ethos of cooperative federalism, that is the states coming up and sharing their responsibility, is also taken care, where the most important thing here is that innovative and new technologies are being used in the construction of houses. You must have been covering in news that a lot of houses and flats which have been provided to the people against this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. So different states are coming on and taking part in this. So yes, that would be all. If you get any other important news which is relevant, you can just mention so that others can also get to know about it. So here is the mobile help center again. It is also important. CRPF has launched the mobile help center for the Amarnath Yatra pilgrims. The mobile help center will be called as Sathi. And CRPF is important because it is the largest central armed police force for the paramilitary force, and it functions under the Ministry of Home Affairs. This you need to know. It is not functioning under the Ministry of Defense, if you can just get confused. So also otherwise, CRPF is the body which is providing the safety and security to Amarnath Yatra pilgrims, and now they have also launched a mobile help center for them, Sathi. So you just need to keep in mind. Okay, so China and India clinched deal to reduce the tariffs on Indian medicines and anti-cancer drugs. So here, since we are talking about China, US and India imposing tariffs and on each other, so here is the news where China has decided to reduce tariffs. That is why this becomes important. Here, the reduction of import duties on Indian medicines, which include anti-cancer drugs as well. So there China has signed a deal. Although the details has not come out yet, but still, since it is another important point in the discussion of the tariffs being imposed, here we need to keep a view on it. So now this is the important news for us to know. Samsung inaugurates world's largest mobile phone factory in India. And India, where is this particular place? It is Noida in Uttar Pradesh. Noida is in the National Capital Region, so it is important for us to know. And Samsung, being a South Korean country, is going to launch its largest mobile factory in India. Now, this inauguration marks the first ever state visit of South Korean President Moon Jae-in to India. So, you just need to know that which president has inaugurated it and where is it going to be set up. Yes, that would be it about this particular news. So another news from the South Korean side. Here, IFFCO has signed pacts with South Korean firms for the provision of the agri equipment and finance business. Now, before moving on to this news, let me just tell you about IFFCO. IFFCO is the Indian Farms Fertilizers Cooperative Limited. It basically is a cooperative society which is multi-state, that is many states are involved in it, and it is one of India's biggest cooperative societies, and it is owned by Indian cooperatives wholly. So now you know its importance. So now IFFCO has entered into a strategic partnership with South Korean agriculture manufacturer so them to provide them the business opportunities in India as well. The farm machinery and agriculture credit sector are still evolving in India, and it is not that much technologically developed. So this is important for us. And another news for South Korea we have read in the previous slide. Moving on. Okay, so first Indian tourism mart to be held in New Delhi. Now you see, since it is the first such mart, so it becomes important for us to know. And secondly, the place where it is going to be held, that is New Delhi. Apart from this, we have to know that who is organizing this. So it will be organized by Ministry of Tourism in partnership with FATE, that is Federation of Associations in Indian Tourism and Hospitality. So these are going to organize this particular event, and the aim is to develop India on the lines of a tourism mart. So yes, that would be it about this particular news. Okay, so another news is related to ADB. We have learned about Asian Development Bank in the previous videos as well. So now ADB has approved the lining project of Sun Canal in Bihar. See, Sun is the, or it is also called as Son, it is the southern tributary of river Ganga, and it has been also called as the Sor of Bihar because of the widespread floods it used to cause earlier. So now ADB has approved the $503 million lining project for Sun Canal in the Shahabad Bhojpur region of Bihar. So that means it is going to bring a lot of benefits to the agriculture sector. And the you can see read about ADB if in case you have missed about it. And secondly, ADB is particularly an important body for us to know. So this is important for us, the Sun Canal, which is to be funded by ADB. Okay, Gujarat government grants religious minority status to Jews. Now see, this news is particularly important because there are only two states apart from Gujarat who have given the status to Jews, which are Maharashtra and West Bengal. So since there are only three states in India have given the religious minority status, so this becomes important for us to know here. Now with this approval, now there are now seven religious minorities in the state of Gujarat. Yes, that would be it about this news. Moving on. Now, this is particularly important. HRD Ministry grants institutions of eminent status to 3 public and 3 private institutes. Now, see, MHRD has given this status for the first time, so it is very important for us to know. And yes, here the expert committee, which was headed by Chief Election Commissioner N. Gopalanaswamy, is also important. You need to know this name also. So these particularly three public sector institutes are IISc Bangalore, IIT Bombay and IIT Delhi. So apart from these three, you also need to know the private sector institutes, which are BITS Pilani, Manipal Academy of Higher Education, that is in Manipal, Karnataka. And the third one is the Greenfield project, that is, it is still under development. It is going to start afresh. It is the Geo Institute of Reliance Foundation in Pune. Now, this you must have heard, because since it was so much in news regarding the controversy that how come this project is in news. So just you need to know all these six public sector as well as private sector institutions. Now, here I've also mentioned that this scheme, that is the IOI, Institutes of Eminence, was rolled by the UGC, and it will help 20 higher education institutions from country to break into the top 500 ranking in 10 years. So that is the aim behind them, to put them in this category. That would be all. Okay, so here is another important news from the state of Gujarat. Gujarat has signed MOU with the Korea Trade Investment Promotion Agency, so as to strengthen the trade and industrial relations. Now you see, let me just tell you about this particular agency, which is also known as KOTRA. It is a national trade and investment promotion organization, and it is operated by South Korean government. So since the Gujarat government has signed an MOU with the agency which is operated by South Korean government, so that is why this news is important for us. And secondly, the background you will be able to get through the next slide, which I am going to tell you. But just note down here that this MOU is aimed to recognize the mutual desire for the enhancing of the trade and industrial investment and the other cooperation between both these states. So just moving on. See, here I have mentioned that Gujarat is a key contributor to India-South Korea economic relations, since the Gujarat exports to South Korea last year was around $1 billion, which is around 25% of India's total export to South Korea. So now you know the importance of the agreement which has been signed. And Gujarat has been a leading destination for the foreign investment, as I have also told you about the gift city, that is the financial tech city, which is the India's first city located in Gujarat for the particularly foreign investment. So in the background, this news becomes important for us to know here. Okay, again South Korea in news. India South Korea Technology Exchange Center inaugurated in New Delhi. Now see, the South Korea Technology Center is going to be inaugurated in New Delhi. This is important for us, and the purpose of the center is to create platform for MSMEs of India as well as South Korea so that they can assist and identify the latest technology and exchange them as well. So in this particular video we have seen a lot about South Korea. So just keep a tab on all these news, and the center is to be inaugurated in New Delhi. This is also important for us. Okay, FSSAI launches Eat Right movement. So this is important for us to know that this movement has been launched by FSSAI to promote the safe and healthy food. Now see, this FSSAI is the nodal statutory agency which is responsible for the promotion of public health in India, and it functions under the aegis of Health and Family Welfare Ministry. So here you need to know that this particular Eat Right movement launched by FSSAI, and the two pillars are Eat Healthy and Eat Safe. So you just need to know about this. Okay, so this news is particularly important here. The Global Innovation Index has placed India at the rank 57th. Now see, this is important since India has improved its ranking from the last year's index. So we need to keep a tab on these news. India was ranked 57th among 130 countries. Last year, India was at 60th rank. India has shown improvement. And second important thing here is that the GII edition was jointly released by Cornell University, INSEAD and WIPO. So these three have together launched this GII edition. So this is also important for us to know. Now you see that India has climbed from 60 to 57. That is why we need to keep the ranking in our minds. You can read about it more if you want to hear, as I've mentioned here. Okay, so another important news is here about Wings. Now see, BSNL has launched India's first internet telephony service. Okay, so since it is launched by the state-owned BSNL, that is why it is important. And secondly, it is the first telephony internet service. So you need to remember this name, Wings. It will allow users to dial any telephone number in India through this mobile app. Earlier, this was not the case. You could call from one app to another app only. But now you'll be able to call different mobile numbers from one particular app. So this Wings has to be kept in mind. And yes, that would be all. Okay, so this is again important. India became sixth largest economy in 2017 according to World Bank. Since it's a release by World Bank, it is important for us to know. Now see, India has surpassed France to become the world's sixth largest economy. So this is again important, but let me just tell you that although India has surpassed France in terms of the GDP, but you know the per capita income is very much low of India as compared to France, because you see the population of France is much much lower than that of India. So although GDP has grown at a larger rate, but the per capita income is very low. And according to World Bank, the surge in India's GDP has been a result of the good performance in the manufacturing sector. Again, this is important now because India's manufacturing sector is seen to be as very ignorant sector, where all the focus is usually on the agriculture or the services sector. So this is again very important in the background of the Make in India and other initiatives launched by the government. So yes, here I've mentioned that WELT, World Economic League Table, released by Center for Economics and Business Research, forecasted that India would be taking over Britain and France in terms of GDP. So their release has almost come true, as India has already taken over France. Yes, that would be it. Okay, so government launches Jal Bachao Video Banao Puraskar Pao contest. Now apart from this contest, it is important to know that which ministry is launching it. It is Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. And secondly, ministry has joined hands with MyGov portal. Now this portal is in itself very important. You can read about this portal and in fact all other important portals of the government of India. So Here the prize amount is mentioned, 25, 15 and 10,000 for the first, second and third positions respectively. So you see, this is basically a kind of contest where government is trying to make people aware, so that if they save water and then put up some video, they are trying to push people to come in the scenario of water saving. So that would be it. Okay, so a very important news related to the agriculture sector. India's genetically modified crop area is fifth largest in the world. Now, you see, there has been a news a lot about BT brinjal, BT cotton, or the genetically modified mustard as well. So in that particular background, this news becomes important here. Now, this report has been released by ISA. You can read about it here. India has become the fifth largest area with the area under the genetically modified crops. So another important thing here is the entire area is under single crop, that is BT cotton. So only one crop which has been approved by government and its cultivation is going on a very large scale is BT cotton. So here it becomes important for us to know. And second, that United States has the highest area under transgenic crops. So this is also important for us to know, that which country has the highest area. Okay, moving on. So the next news is again related to a very important international body, that is EBRD. Now India has formally announced as being its 69th shareholder. See, there were announcements earlier that India is going to join EBRD. So now this is the formal announcement which has come. What is important here to know is that EBRD, that is European Bank for Reconstruction and Development Bank, has now 69 members and India is the latest member. And secondly, though India has joined EBRD as a shareholder, but it will not be a recipient of the bank's financing. Now this is also an important clause for us to know. And yes, the inaugural business forum was held in Mumbai, so this place also becomes important for us to know. Okay, so Indian Army inks MOU with SBI on defense salary package. So the MOU has been signed with which bank is important in this news. And the revised version of first MOU has been signed. Now currently Indian Army has MOUs on defense salary package with 11 public and private sector banks. The latest one has been signed with SBI. Okay, so this is again important, Dharohar Bhavan. So Prime Minister has launched the headquarter building of Archaeological Survey of India. Before moving on to this news, let me just tell you about the ASI. It is the premier organization for the archaeological research. It is basically under the Ministry of Culture and it was established in 1861. That was at the time of the rule of the Britishers. So it is still going on and it is working really well. So that is why it is important. And secondly, about this Dharohar Bhavan, which is the headquarter of the ASI, has been launched in New Delhi. So yes, that would be it about this. Okay, so another important appointment for us to note down here. Former diplomat TCA Raghavan has been appointed as the Director General of Indian Council of World Affairs. Now, before seeing about this particular appointment, let me just tell you about ICWA. Here it is mentioned, you can read about. It says that it was established in 1943 by a group of Indian intellectuals as a think tank. So basically, it is a non-official and non-profit body which is working as a think tank. And important point here is that Vice President of India is its ex-officio president. That means whosoever is the Vice President is by default the President of ICWA. So now Vice President of India has appointed Dr. TCA Raghavan as its Director General. So the name here is important for us to know. Okay, moving on. Okay, so another important news is here. Government has raised the threshold monetary limit for filing appeals which are relating to tax cases. Usually there are three levels of appeal, that is appellate tribunal, high courts and supreme courts, where a person who is aggrieved can go for the appeal. And now the government has raised the tax limit, that is it has been made 20 lakh from presently 10 lakh at the appellate level and at the appellate tribunal level, and secondly for high court it has been made rupees 50 lakh and for supreme court it has been hiked rupees 1 crore. So you see such a very large increase, so this becomes important for us. And here I've mentioned for you guys to note down that tax department loses 65% of its cases usually. So that means most of the cases are lost by tax department. So this mechanism is there to basically help the people out in the such format. So moving on to the next last news of the day, it says Nilgiri Tahar, climate change is threatening 60% of its habitat. So basically Nilgiri Tahar is a wild goat and it is endemic to Western Ghats from Nilgiris to Kanyakumari. See, it is an endangered animal and it is also found in the red data book of IUCN, which has labeled it as endangered, and it is also protected under Schedule 1 of Wildlife Act of 1972. So that is why it is very important, and only 2500 Nilgiri Tahars are left in wild. So and the report says that 60% of its habitat is endangered due to climate change. So it is important for us to keep a tab on this. And secondly, you can just read here that it is also the state animal of Tamil Nadu. So yes, that would be it. So thank you guys. That was about the comprehensive coverage of news from the past 5 days. And if you have any query, you can visit our website anytime. That is www.edutab.co.in. You can even drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can even give us a call at 8146207241. Okay, just note down the link of the Telegram channel where you'll be able to download the content sheet of this video particularly and the series of the video. So just go and download the content sheet so that it is helpful in your study. So thank you guys, have a happy learning, and please do like, subscribe and share this video.